Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, the participants of summer course of Family of Human Ecology, IPB University. May I introduce myself? My name is Herin Puspitawati. You may call me Herin. I am the head division of Family Science, Department of Family and Consumer Sciences, Faculty of Human Ecology, IPB University. On this honorable occasion, I will present my lecture with the title of Gender and Family Resilience Toward Future Worlds in Indonesia. This is my curriculum vitae. And these are the books that I have been published by IPB Press on family sciences. The outlines for this presentation are definition of gender and family, family conditions during the COVID-19 pandemic, gender and family resilience strategy, and examples of research on gender and family resilience. As introduction, family is the first and main educator for all human beings. Family is the school of love and trainers of management of stress, management of psychosocial, mental, and spiritual, and educator of character building. And the last is to educate women is to educate the whole nation. Common questions about family and child problems. Why are there so many poor families, divorce, conflict, and stress? Why are there still many child marriages, violence against children, children dropping out of school, and children without having a birth certificate? Why are there still children who are stunted and malnourished? Why are some children stressed and behave negatively, breaking the law? And why are babies dumped, etc. and etc.? All answers lie in the family roles and functions. The first section, we are talking about the definition of gender and family. Challenges of family and gender studies toward future worlds, because gender and family are cross-cutting issues, with placing gender as substance problems as well as solutions. And family as the media that must be optimized function as the smallest unit of society. Indonesia has faced a variety of negative social and economic issues such as poverty, economic hardship for the family, trafficking, juvenile delinquency, terrorism, domestic violence, divorce, and street children. All of these challenges require the importance of family and gender studies in tackling the impact of climate change and the negative impact of technological developments, as well as the globalization and millennium era. Why study gender and family studies? Because one is to understand gender roles among families, both farmers and non-farmers, and also to know who does what in agricultural activities, and help to respond to poverty alleviation, reduce inefficiency in labor, and reduce conflicts, and increase the gender partnerships to achieve family well-being. The definition of gender is the difference between men and women in roles, functions, rights, responsibilities, and behaviors, which are shaped by the social, cultural, and customary values of community groups, which can change according to time and local conditions. And gender relations and partnership is the relationship and cooperation between men and women related to the roles that each run on a variety of family types and structures. And gender equality and equity, we are taking from the USAID definition, that gender equality permits women and men equal enjoyment of human rights, socially valued goods, opportunities, resources, and the benefits from development results. Gender equity is the process of being fair to women and men. To ensure fairness, measures must be available to compensate for historical and social disadvantages that prevent women and men from operating on a level playing field. Gender equity strategies are used to eventually gain gender equality. So equity is the means, equality is the result. The form of gender equality and equity, there are 4 points. First, access means how anyone enters or uses the resources. The second, participation means who does what. The third, control means who has what. And the fourth, benefits means who gets what. Now we are discussing the importance of family roles in forming or shaping human resources. Quality of human resources consists of 3 dimensions. First, physical health. The second, mental, spiritual health. And the third, cognitive intelligence. Family roles as a former or shaper of human resources, it means as the smallest unit in society, which is the first and foremost institutions for human resources development. An institution that has an obligation to meet the needs of its children, which include religion, character education, psychology, eating, drinking, and protection. The family is an organization that gives birth to offspring, raises children, and lives side by side for a long time. The family is the pillar of a nation as the smallest socioeconomic unit in society, which is the basic foundation of all community and state institutions. Here is the family structure, consists of father and mother in intact families, or father only or mother only in a single parent family, and children both girl and or boy. Each of family member has roles and functions, responsibility, right, and status with family life cycle approach. Concept of family resilience from family unit system perspective is related to crisis and stress, according to McCubbin and colleagues, 1996, involves a dynamic process of positive adaptation of the difficulties of the family unit, according to Patterson, 2002, Walls and Walls, 1996, and Walls, 2013. Family's ability to survive and recover from the life's challenges, according to Wolf, and focus on the strength of the family under stress, during crisis, and when faced with prolonged difficulty, according to Wolf. There are 24 indicators of family resilience, according to Ministry of Women Empowerment and Child Protection and Center of Statistic Bureau, 2013 and 2016, with dimensions of legal structures, gender partnerships, physical, economical, social, psychological, and social cultural resiliences. The end result of human resources is to be holistic human or whole perfect human. However, adolescents or teenagers are in the stage of storm and stress. That is why gender-responsive parenting is very crucial. And the second section, we are talking about family conditions during the COVID-19 pandemic. We have a method of research, a survey conducted by online survey guided by a questionnaire on April 8 to May 15, 2020. The sampling method used a non-probability voluntary sampling. The unit analysis were families with criteria of an intact family, husband and wife, with or without a child. Number of respondents who were completed all items in the questionnaire were 1,591 from 29 provinces in Indonesia. The families were categorized into two geographic zones of pandemic COVID-19. One, families living in Jabodetabek region, and two, families living in outer Jabodetabek region. The study were analyzed by using different independent tests, Pearson correlation tests, and structural equation modeling, or SEM, using Lisrel. And Cronbach alpha for all items were reliable. Respondents were 72% females and 27% males. 70% living in Jabodetabek and 29% living in outer Jabodetabek. 82% husbands and head of occupation and 35% wives has occupation. 64% families had children of one and two person, and 74 families had length of family marriage more than 10 years. Number of respondents who completed the questionnaire were 1591, as stated before, as a representative of families from 29 provinces in Indonesia. Based on dyadic relations among married couples during COVID-19 pandemic, it can be known that there were anger and hating, as well as caring and helping between husband and wife during COVID-19 pandemic in Indonesia. The third section, we are talking about gender and family resilience strategy. Gender strategy in family life can be applied into gender partnership in families, gender responsive parenting, balancing work and family, and optimize household production. To enhance family strengthening strategy, there must be a renovation of the gender partnership system in the family towards harmony and resilience toward the new normal. Gender partnerships can be applied on restoring roles and functions in family resilience and well-being, restoration of family economic function, and education recovery and child protection. And gender responsive parenting consists of directions from parents to child, socializations and education from parents to child, affection, bonding, attachment, dyadic communication and interactions between parents and child, and the fourth is commitments between parents and child. Gender responsive parenting is taking into account the individual characteristics of men and women with consideration of gender needs as humans, special needs related to gender, physiological anatomy and hormones, and the uniqueness individual character. The first section, we are talking about examples of research on gender and family resilience. And the usefulness of research on gender and family in higher education is to identifying family problems, to provide policy briefs to the government from the results of research as evidence-based theory, to overcome gender and family problems through the preparation of programs and activities for communities. Research findings from our research study one is the analysis of gender division of labor in farmer families with sample 110 and the role of the domestic with reproductive family activities are, it is interesting to note that as the typical patriarchal family system, the division of domestic roles and reproductive activities were more dominated by wives. The activity of the equivalent domestic roles performed by the husband and wife were looking for a way to solve the family's financial problems. None of the domestic role of family activities was dominated by the husband. Here is the table. We have studied two, a gender analysis of agricultural socialization toward child and child investment among highland farmer families in West Java, Indonesia. And this is model of family subjective well-being in rural and suburban families at Cianjur and Bogor Regencies. It can be known that child characteristics has positive effect on relations of child and parents. It means that girl has more values on child and parents relationship rather than boys. And relation of child parents has positive effect on family and child subjective well-being. It means that the more child and parents has relationship, positive relationship, then it can be effect on family and child subjective well-being. This is the model of relationships of subjective well-being between family and child model. It means that family subjective well-being that has two dimensions, material and non-material, very related high relationship with child subjective well-being that consists of material and non-material dimensions too. It means if family subjective well-being is high, then relate to subjective well-being of the child is also high too. This is model construct validity of child investment. So to measure child investment can be done holistically. There are four dimensions: time allocation of togetherness between parents and child, education, health and investment, material allocation, and also protection of the child. So it means child investment can be shown by that four dimensions. This is model construct validity of child quality that consists of five dimensions: physical, achievements, behaviors, psychosocial and spiritual, and also quality of life. This is the model, the effect of child investment on child quality. So it can be known that child investment index has positive effect on child quality index. It means if the parents has investment on the child, then the child will be qualified with higher human being. As closing for these presentations are: gender can be practiced in family life, family strengthening strategies that consist of gender partnership in the family, gender-based childcare, balancing work and family, and also optimizing household production. Given an example of the results of gender analysis and family resilience with the use of providing policy briefs to the government from the research results are evidence-based on theory. Thank you very much for your kind attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.